Using this method that you are about to see now, you can add any Victron device with VE.Direct port in Home Assistant. In my video from last week, I added a Victron MPPT and an Echo inverter in my camper, so that I can have a AC electricity inside. Today, I'll add that Victron MPPT in my Home Assistant, so I can see the Victron readings on my Home Assistant dashboard. To do that, I'll connect one cheap ESP board to the VE.Direct port of the Victron MPPT. I'll flash that ESP board with ESPHome so that Home Assistant will be able to communicate with that board, and as a result I'll have all of the important sensors inside my Home Assistant. I'll show you what I did in details, and I'll share all the tips and tricks and of course difficulties that I faced, so you can avoid them beautifully. Before I begin, I just want to say big thank you to my friend Grigor, who not only guided me during the whole process, starting from choosing the right components, through researching and even sending me some parts like connectors and level shifters. So, thank you Grigor, I needed that help and I truly appreciate that. Now, let's start this video. I will use a D1 mini board, which is an ESP8266 board that can be bought from AliExpress for less than $4. I will show you how I wired everything later in the video, because now I want to say few words about Home Assistant and ESPHome. There is a nice change here that I'll try to explain. ESPHome dashboard is needed for this project so that I can upload the ESP software to the D1 mini or any other ESP board using a simple micro USB cable. There are several ways to run the ESPHome dashboard, and they are all well explained in this video of mine. However, one of the easiest way is to use the one-click installable ESPHome dashboard add-on, available in Home Assistant add-on store. For that, of course, you need a working Home Assistant installation type with add-on store. To understand which Home Assistant installation type have that damn add-on store and everything around this topic, I'm personally inviting you to my upcoming webinar, where I'll be talking exactly about that. What are the official methods to start Home Assistant and their pros and cons? So, go and reserve your seat right now on my website, and you can see the link on your screen, and it is also available in the video description. It is all free. As summary, to make this project working, a Victron device with VE.Direct port is needed. That could be a MPPT, inverter, shunt, and many more. Also, an ESP board like the D1 mini, a micro USB cable, and few wires are also needed. It is not a bad idea to get one 4-pin GST 2.0 PH connector for the VE.Direct port, unless you find some other ways to connect to the Victron device physically. I will put some affiliate links in the video description to all of the needed components, and if you want to check their current prices in AliExpress and Amazon. If you buy something from these links, you support my channel, because I'll receive a small commission from your purchases with no additional cost for you. Next thing that I did is the actual wiring. Here is how I connected everything, and I connected the TX pin on the Victron device to the D7 pin on the D1 mini board. Next, I connected the ground from the Victron device to the ground pin on the D1 mini board. Next, I'll connect the D1 mini board to the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome are running. In my case, it is a Raspberry Pi 4. I plan to leave that cable permanently, because the VE.Direct port is not having enough power to powering the D1 mini board. And now, the fun part begins. While I'm inside Home Assistant, I'll open my ESPHome dashboard. I have it in my sidebar. Then I'll click on this new device or this new device button, it doesn't matter. Then I'll click continue. The name also doesn't matter. In my case, it will be Victron MPPT. Then I'll enter my Wi-Fi name and password. Then I'll click next. I'll choose ESP8266 board, because D1 mini is such a board. And then I'll click skip, because I don't want to install ESPHome yet. Then I'll click on the edit button, and I'll head on to the Jiri's GitHub page, GitHub project of the Victron MPPT ESPHome, and I'll open this file, smartsolar MPPT ESP8266 example, and I'll copy everything by clicking on this button. Then I'll go to my ESPHome dashboard again, and I'll select everything, and I'll overwrite it with the copied code. You can get that code from the video description or from the Jiri's GitHub page. Now is the best moment to say that all the credits here for the code are going to Jiri from Czech Republic, which is the author of this integration, and of course his contributors. As I said, I'll leave a link to his GitHub repo in the video description if you want to check it out. I'll make just a few changes here. I'll uncomment this API because I want this to work using the native Home Assistant API, and I'll comment the MPPT section. If you have an MPPT broker, you can leave it as it is, but I don't want to use it. I'll use the API, the Home Assistant native API instead. Everything else will stay as it is. I'll hit save, then I'll hit install, and I'll select this plugin to the computer running ESPHome dashboard option. Before that, I connected my D1 Mini to the Raspberry Pi 4 where Home Assistant and ESPHome dashboard are running. I'll select the server port here and the installation begins. After around 5 minutes, the installation is now complete and I can close this window. I can also close this editor and my Victron MPPT device is now online. I can check the logs wirelessly because ESPHome device is already running. And as you can see, I have some readings. This is the battery voltage, 13.47, and so on and so forth. This is a very good sign. I can close this. As a next step, I'll open my Home Assistant integrations page, and inside I'll find my auto-discovered new ESPHome device. And I'll go to my integration section. And here it is, one new device, Victron MPPT. Is discovered. I can click configure, submit. I'll choose an area, but this is optional, of course, and then finish. This is my new device, one device with 23 entities. If I click on it, I'll see all of the sensors that Victron MPPT have: battery voltage, charging mode, load current, yield today, yield total, panel power, max power today, everything seems to work. Great. I can add this to my dashboard. I'll add it like that and now beautify it later. Here it is. As comparison, I'll show the readings from the VictronConnect mobile app on my phone and the readings in Home Assistant, and the numbers are matching. All of that means that I can now stop using the mobile app and start using my Home Assistant either from the internet or from my smart control panel. As next step, I can make few automations that can notify me when something is wrong or when some thresholds are reached. Also, I can play a bit to make this data more beautiful using some different Home Assistant cards. If some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, make sure that you download my smart home glossary available in my website automatelike.pro/glossary. It is all free. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill. See you next week. Bye.